Welcome all viewers. We are here to discuss in the paper operating system the topic CPU scheduler and dispatcher. After reading this lesson and listening to this lecture, you will be able to understand clearly the concept of CPU scheduler and the dispatcher. Let's move on. So, what is the CPU scheduler? But before going with that CPU scheduler, if you remember in the last classes, we have discussed about the scheduling criteria of the, you know, CPU scheduling. So there was the first criteria like to maximize the CPU utilization. What is the need of this, you know, scheduling techniques or scheduling philosophies is there to maximize the CPU utilization. So what does the CPU scheduler does? We need to understand like what our CPU scheduler is. So by now we must already have a, you know, brief idea about the scheduling, what is actually scheduling is there. So what is a CPU scheduler? It says here, when the CPU becomes idle, the operating system, you know, must select one of the processes in the ready queue to be executed. The, you know, selection process is carried out, you know, by the short-term scheduler, or you can say CPU scheduler. So that CPU, CPU scheduler select a process from the processes in the memory that are ready to execute, and then allocate the CPU to that process. So from the name, you know, itself, we can say that indicate that the CPU scheduler is the one who is going to select the process that will get the CPU for its execution. So we know that scheduling means assigning the CPU for the different purposes to the different processes, you know, for their execution. So here, you know, maybe any process that are ready to be executed and are waiting to just get the CPU, you know, among the different processes, those are processes which are already, you know, possess the CPU, scheduler is the one who will select which process will get the CPU in order to its execution. So what will do, it will select a process from the processes in the memory and that are ready to execute, and it will allocate the CPU to that process. So that is a function of the CPU scheduler. So similarly, there is, you know, another thing that we need to you know, understand about this scheduling. But before that, let's move on this figure. I hope from this you can easily understand what is the meaning of this scheduler. So this is the, you know, ready queue, and this ready queue contain the processes which are ready to execute, which are ready to take over the CPU. And that is the waiting queue. That waiting queue is that queue that all the processes which are needed for the input or output operation, whatever the inputting or outputting of requirement by the process, that goes into that waiting queue. That we already discussed in the, you know, process state, that ready queue, that waiting state. So first process goes to the ready queue, and then it will execute it. It will run, and then after that, if it requires some input or output, it you know, wait in that waiting queue for completion of, you know, input or output, depending on the availability of input device or the output device. And then again, this after completion of this input output, it will goes back to the ready queue. This was the concept initially for the process state. So what does this you know, CPU scheduler does? CPU scheduler from this select the process which are ready to execute from this ready queue, and through this ready queue, that you know, short term scheduler select which process is going to be executed by this CPU. So, जो भी प्रोसेसेस इस रेडी क्यू के अंदर लगे हुए हैं, उन सब प्रोसेसेस में से भी कौन सा प्रोसेस सीपीयू के पास जाएगा, विच प्रोसेस विल एग्जीक्यूट द फर्स्ट एंड देन विच प्रोसेस कम्स फर्स्ट, दैट ऑल डिसाइडेड बाय दिस शॉर्ट टर्म शेड्यूलर, और यू कैन से दिस सीपीयू शेड्यूलर. सो वेन एवर यू नो द सीपीयू बिकम्स आइडल, द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम मस्ट सेलेक्ट वन ऑफ द प्रोसेसेस इन द रेडी क्यू to be executed, and then the selection, you know, process is carried out by this short term scheduler. So I hope it is clear to you all. This short term scheduler is also known as a CPU scheduler as well. So there may be a question like what is a short term scheduler or the CPU scheduler, write the difference between the long term scheduler and the CPU short term scheduler. there may be a, you know, 2 mark question in the examination, or there may be a 4 marks question, maybe come from the scheduler point of view. 2 marks as well, but not 12 marks question. So that is all about, you know, short term scheduler and CPU scheduler. So that it means that the scheduler selects from among the processes in memory that are ready to execute and allocate the process. Process means that the processor means that the CPU to one of them. So the ready queue is in, you know, not necessarily in first out queue. Like it is not compulsory that queue must be in FIFO order only. We will discuss this on later on classes when we will discuss about this, like scheduling policies and preemptive and non-preemptive scheduling. But as of now, you understand that it is not compulsory to allocate to that that all the processes are come in the FIFO, you know, manner, and they execute in this manner. It is not compulsory. So when the process comes from the ready queue and select, and that process execute by this CPU, that is selected by this short term scheduler. Now when the process comes from that memory, the, you know, all the processes are resided in the secondary memory, or you can say permanent memory, and the process which is currently executed, which is the program which is in execution, you know, is not a process, is a process. The program which is in execution is not, is known as a process. This already we discussed in the previous classes. So the process, the program which is in execution, that means abhi wo currently run kar raha hai process. So jab wo currently run kar raha hai, all of you must be aware about these things, that all the processes which are currently running are resigned in the main memory, you can say, or the temporary memory. So all the processes which are pulled back, you know, in this memory, so that they are ready to execute, that function is performed by this long-term scheduler. So that is the long-term scheduler that pulls the, you know, program, that pulls the processes from secondary to this you know, main memory, so that they can execute. And short-term scheduler is that scheduler which execute or which select the process from this ready queue to the CPU. Now next is the third one type, is the medium-term scheduler. That is the another scheduler is there. So that medium term scheduler is what, as I told you, like say for example, if there are the 1, 2, 3, 4, just wait. Say for example, if there are the two processes are there, say this is process 1, this is process 2, this is process 3, and this is process 4. This is just for example, it is not like that, always it is seeing like that. So say for example, if these four processes are arriving in this ready queue in this manner, and this short term scheduler select this process P1, this process P1, okay, what is the dispatcher? Soon we will be discussed. That process goes to that, you know, CPU for the execution. Okay, now this process is running. Okay, very nice. If it is, you know, completed by its process processing, then it will goes into this end state, or you can say it will terminate. Now comes the next process, that is process 2. This is only for indicative, you know, this is not compulsory that first process 1 come and then process 2 come. This is not necessary. Now again, say if we are imagining, you know, let us, you know, imagine that, okay, second process after that first process comes, that will goes to the CPU. Okay, it is start processing, it is running. By the meantime, it requires some inputting and outputting of data. So what will happen? It will goes back from this, you know, CPU processor to this inputting and outputting of data. And why is this so? So say for example, if there is two processes there, number 2, so it will put in the waiting queue like 2. Now again, say for example, that 3 number of process will come, because now again that processes wait for input output now. So in that state, in that, you know, situation, in this situation, CPU cannot become idle. It has to be executed something else. So say for example, this process, this come, process 3, and again it is executing, again it is, you know, needed that processing to be executed. So what will be the case in this case? In this case, that process P2 come to, you know, that process P3 come after that. Say for example, that was the earlier process 2, and if process 3 also requires, it will put it like this. So it again wait for the inputting and outputting of data, and as soon as, say for example, this P2 process completed its input output. Now what will happen? Say for example, this is the process P2 completed in input output, and already this process P3 is already, you know, using the some input output devices. So in that case, that process P2 through that medium term scheduler go to that ready queue and put in this situation. That is the case. As this process P3 is come back here, so we can remove his from here, from this situation. And similarly, if process P2 is there for the waiting queue, we can remove this process P2 from here. So now this is the case. Now these four process. Now this 2 is come, so that fourth number of processes shifted like this. And you can say now that process P2 will come, and that process P2 place here because its input output completed now. Therefore, it will place in this situation, like this is the process P2. So what will happen? That long term scheduler takes from secondary memory to the main memory. That short term scheduler takes from, you know, ready queue to that execution state, and that medium term scheduler keeps the processes from this waiting queue to the, you know, ready queue. So this is the basically meaning of the scheduler. Next term is dispatcher. What is that dispatcher? Dispatcher, you know, what does it, you know, the dispatcher is the, you know, module that gives control of the CPU to the process selected by the short term scheduler. So what does dispatcher does is that it will give the control of the CPU, you know, to the, just wait, control of the CPU, you know. So we see that there are a different number of processes are waiting to memory to be executed, and they are ready to be executed, and that means that they are ready to get the CPU. So what the CPU scheduler does, it will select one of the process and say that, okay, yes, you are the one that is going to get the CPU to begin your execution. And what is a dispatcher do? Dispatcher is a module, you know, that actually gives control of the CPU to that particular process that was selected by the CPU scheduler. So iska matlab pehle CPU scheduler select karta hai process ko, uske baad dispatcher ka kaam shuru hota hai. So we need to understand that dispatcher has to be very quick, because there are a lot of processes are, you know, switching between the one process to the another process. So it is very fast. So different processes are waiting for the CPU, and when one process is executing and goes into the waiting state, we need to give the CPU to another process. So this happens, you know, very frequently, and the switching between these processes, you must happen very quickly as well. So the dispatcher has to be very quick. And so the time it takes for the dispatcher, you know, to stop one process and then start another running process, now that is known as the dispatch latency. So that is the meaning of dispatch latency, the time which is taken by this dispatcher to stop one process and to start another process. So in this figure, you can see that there is the process, say for example, P0 is executing. And by the meantime, if this is executing, its state is saved in the PCB0, that is a process control block, which we already discussed in our previous classes. And then it restore the state of the process P1 and then start executing. So at the moment the dispatcher stop that execution of that process P0, and the moment that it start executing the process P1, so the time between both of these is known as a dispatch latency. So there may be a question, what is the meaning of dispatch latency? So dispatch latency is time taken by the dispatcher to stop one process and start another running process. So I hope this is clear to you all. That is the dispatch latency. So basically dispatcher, you know, module gives control of the CPU to the processes to select by the CPU scheduler. It can be done, you know, by switching of the context, by switching of the user mode, and by jumping on to the, you know, proper location as well. So I hope this is you know, clear to you all. These are some reference book you can refer to more you know, explore about this you know, CPU scheduler and the dispatcher and the dispatch latency. So this is all about for today's lecture. In later on classes, we will discuss about the scheduling philosophies, and in which we will discuss about the preemptive scheduling and non-preemptive scheduling. So keep watching this space. Thank you for patiently listening and watching this video. Thank you.